Hello, Professor. We are from the Interdisciplinary Academic Society and we are here to ask you some questions. So the first question is, what is your idea of interdisciplinariness and how does that bring out the significance of interdisciplinary?
Of the symposium itself, of the conference itself. So interdisciplinary for me means multiple perspectives on any one idea. So just to the lead up to Ashoka, when we were doing, when many faculty members were doing workshops across the country to various demographics, and it's a workshop that I still do, I really wanted to capture this idea of interdisciplinarity because I wanted to sort of showcase what it is that Ashoka stands for. And so the workshop that I did was called 10 Ideas About Love, or 10 Ways of Thinking About Love. And each of those 10 ways was drawn from a different disciplinary perspective. So how does psychology allow us to think about love? How does history allow us to think about love? Sociology, physics, computer science. And so in fact, all the subjects that we're offering at Ashoka, I looked at all of them to think about how they allow us to think about love. And for me, that's what the process always is. And in that process, of course, the very idea of love refuses to be singular. It becomes 10 different ideas and then potentially 100 different ideas. So for me, interdisciplinarity is always that which allows any one idea to become multiple, to sort of take on shapes and forms and faces that we might never have known and recognized at first. And so the symposium or the conference that you're planning on interdisciplinaria, for me, what I would like to see from it, and what I certainly saw in it last year, is precisely this multiplicity of faces and multiplicity of formal engagements with any one idea.
So what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word chaos? How would you define it? And what do you think about it as a theme for a symposium based on interdisciplinarity?
Yeah, I mean, like a good student awed by physics, that when I first hear chaos, I always think of chaos theory. And think about, you know, how amazing that is. But what's interesting to me about chaos theory is the word theory itself. And because I am a theorist and I am a literary theorist, I'm very interested in what or how theory allows us to think about the world. Because of course theory, as you know, comes from the Greek word for stepping aside and observing and commenting, right? So the theorine in Greek drama was typically what we would call the chorus. People who stood on the side and actually observed what was going on and then would write up, or not write up, or report on what was going on. And so a theorist has to, by definition, observe, listen, read, study, analyze. And all those activities coming together in relation to chaos is something that I've always found fascinating. Because theory, of course, always exists in relation to chaos. You can think of theory on the one hand as a desire for systematicity, right? As a desire for making rules within which to bring order to chaos. On the other hand, which is the way in which I do theory, the way to think about theory is how to bring out the chaotic nature of chaos, how to actually appreciate what makes chaos fruitful and productive, rather than saying, okay, here are the rules by which we can understand chaos and put a lid on it. Let's think about how actually to allow chaos to explode and think about how we can understand that explosion, not in terms of regulating it, but in terms of reveling in what it allows us to do. So that's what I think of when I think of chaos. And so as, I think your second question was, how do we understand it? We can't. And that's what makes it such an important idea for interdisciplinarity.
I think we had a lot of these discussions and you've captured 6 months of our discussion.
Good.
We had the privilege of having you as our speaker for the inaugural symposium.
Yeah.
And that symposium was a success. And so I would like to know that what are your expectations from the coming symposium, which is IB 2016?
Yeah. What I really liked about symposium last year was that you brought together fairly improbable elements and made it work. I think my favorite event of the entire evening was the slam poetry, the four women. Was it four women who performed? Because I was astonished by how good they were. They were just amazing. And I'm not a big fan of slam poetry because I think more often than not it gets done badly. And so, you know, people are sort of trying to sort of express their adolescent angst and it just becomes tedious. But these women were smart, were clever, were passionate, and just sort of encapsulating everything I think an Ashoka student needs to be. And they didn't, they were not precious about it at all. They were not, oh, look at what I'm doing here. I am an artist performing. And I thought that worked really well. So what I would like to see more of this year is really that kind of student performance at that caliber of really intellectually grappling with the subject without being precious about it or without sort of wanting to put their paw print on it and say, I own this, but actually opening up a question as a field for everyone in the audience to think about. So that's what I want to see this year too.